seem to believe in the possibility of improvement. That standing up straight one day will lead to standing straighter the next. But all that's just posturing. Who's got time for it? I want to be the path light drinks, the swinging lamp and the arm that moves it. I want to take God by the throat, and I want to be that throat. But everything is so boring. Some days there's a quiver in my groin and it's just the phone in my pocket. Other days I'm the future, grooming its boldest flaws. Normal boys. A normal boy would meet in an old car, a dubious hello, a radio playing. He would meet even in his sleep, a ranch with spiky things guarding its perineum. He would meet in a tight box with a tight lid and a pale light bulb indicating daylight, a crank turning in its side. Hello, I am aberrant girl looking high in a felt sailboat. I have tripped on many a threshold and fallen behind in my vaccinations. You are normal boy with a penchant and a webcam. We're stupidly gorgeous together. Can you not see? My oldest, darkest love, where are you now? You come to me sometimes in the guise of a man I cannot love because he is not you. I see you in there and lean in close as I dare. This man is tiring of me. All men are tiring of me. I am the most tired man of all. From the eye that wants to see a blood war, a catastrophe. Then there's the eye staring out without want from its blistered drape, the eye that flirts on, forever skewered, trading on its shadow. Bring it forth, you say. Let's beat God at his game. Shake out the blankets, the blanks, the tanked and the tricked. Bring it forth, what prowls beneath, invisible cur that bites me so, that bites me so. It's going so quickly. Ballet. It's so beautiful to me. be brokenhearted, but it can't last. Still, one tries through daily reenactments. Nail one foot to the floor, the other describes an arc with its toe. These last two pieces are newer. This one was a little bit inspired by the Gertrude Stein exhibit at the Contemporary Jewish Museum, just hearing her words and feeling her presence and sort of getting her permission to do whatever the fuck, you know. So things to take with us. I would want a bag of sugar. We can practice restraint by eating one grain per day. Could a person even taste one grain of sugar on the end of her fingertip? She could if it was her job. Then when the bag is empty, we can use it for shelter or tear out the inner lining and write on it. What will we write? Sweet things. A good mattress. We are not so young anymore. We need a good mattress. I do believe that the universe provides. When I needed nothing, I had nothing. Now that I need things, I am able to acquire them. I only hope I am not judged too harshly by those who still need nothing. A dictionary is more important than a comb, that is certain. But a comb is so lightweight, there is no need to jettison it in favor of more important things. A dictionary, however. I am afraid my ceramic knives will be useless, as they require professional sharpening. Yes, of course, a suicide kit. You're so practical, darling. When we again need nothing, we will have nothing. The mommy is no longer able to get pregnant. Therefore, the daddy must impregnate the daughter if the human race is to continue. This is so distasteful, they cannot speak of it, and tacitly postpone the decision, at least until the son reaches puberty and there will be options. all right, this last one is for Suzanne. Where's Suzanne? Oh, Suzanne. Oh, no, there you are.
Yeah.
No, like, I've been waiting for that. Sorry, I can't see. So last time I read this piece, Suzanne posted something on Facebook afterwards that said, Sarah Fran quoted me as saying, so my last poem of the evening is called Arkansas Snake Fuck. In tearing myself off of you, I leave a big chunk of myself sort of hanging off your midsection. There isn't time to go back and pry it off, so we part that way. In getting dressed, you find you have to use the last hole on your leather belt to fit it around your new thickness. It's never had the steel prong pushed through its aperture before, and it feels tight, like fucking someone's ass after getting used to the pliable silk of their pussy. And soon, you're getting hard again, thinking about fucking me in the ass, though we haven't done that yet. Meanwhile, I'm sort of delighted by how light I feel, torn open and insubstantial, leaking out important fluids and organs, but so slowly I'm not dead yet. Only vaguely aware of death as a possible result of being so open and permeable. The flaps of my skin where the rest of me tore off from feel fluttery and agitated, the way manta rays look moving through water, like flattened lungs breathing. Fire has to breathe too. In Arkansas, lighting a cigarette off another cigarette is called a snake fuck. It's also worth noting that a snake slithers right out of its own dead skin, but it's still the same snake. What else can I say, if anything, to comfort you? To convince you we can keep keep this thing going, burning end to burning end, even